You hold a win over the BMF of the UFC. You hold a win over Jorge.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Him and I, we cool, right? We see each other. Yeah. We see each other once in the blue. And, hey, what's up? Boom, right? He hates that loss. He really hates that loss. Sorry, he hates that loss, right? So, look, Georgie, you're watching this, you know? You want to avenge your fight, your loss? Come to the dark side.
Oh man!
Straight to the title.
Here's why that will be clipped tonight.
Yeah, we'll be tagging Jorge Masvidal. Don't you worry. I think that would be extra special because you both grew up. Both your roots is bare knuckle. I mean, look, you grew up.
Look, when I fought Jorge, he was fighting overseas, and I had just started fighting. Look, the very first fight that I saw, the very first professional MMA fight that I ever saw, it was Masvidal's fight. I went over there and I saw him fight and I said, man, I want to fight that guy one day. I didn't have no fights yet. I want to fight that guy one day to my trainer, right? To my ex-trainer. And he says, we will. And sure enough, years later, he's fighting overseas. He was in Japan. You know, I think it was Bulldog. And I hear that he wanted to do a home fight before going to the UFC. And in that time, I was fighting for G-Force. Glenn Rice, you ever heard of Glenn Rice, the three-point shooter for the Miami Heat? He had his own organization called G-Force. And that event, this dude, the promoter Tito, this is the story that I heard. Tito and Glenn Rice were in a club, and Masvidal was there, and they were all talking back and forth, and my name came up, and Masvidal was like, I don't know who that guy is. Never heard of him, you know, and it's all good. Maybe he did it, you know? You know, but I fight in front of you. Like, I fight in front of thousands of people, whatever. The guy's nobody. Okay, so you're fighting. So we made a fight happen. You know, he was going back and forth. They made a fight happen. Fight night comes, and the weigh-ins, and I was on weight. And Masvidal was 8 pounds heavy. What? 8 pounds overweight. Yeah. And he was not trying to cut those 8 pounds either. He didn't want to fight. You know, maybe he thought the fight was beneath him or something, you know, but it was, man, the fight was in a AAA arena in Miami. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't a little small whatever.
Yeah.
It was a nice event, you know? And it was a nice venue, nice event, and we were the main event. And he didn't want to cut the weight. You know how they give you 2 hours to cut the weight, right?
Yep,
he was sipping water in front of me and shit. I'm like, oh, hell no, man. I'm like, but I look at the commission. I'm like, look at this dude, man. He's not even trying to cut the weight. He's just drinking water in front of me. You know, and the commissioner was like, oh, don't worry about it. He's going to have to pay for the weight. Like, no, I told him, no, he doesn't want to even pay for the weight. He says he's not going to fight. So the commissioner was like, oh, really? Okay, we'll make an example out of him. It's either he's going to pay you for the weight that he didn't make, right? Or we're going to suspend him for a year. So when they went to go talk to him, they told him it was good. You know, he thought he was going to get out of the fight. So they told him, look, first of all, in the Miami, in the Police Athletic Commission of the Commission of Miami, in Florida, you can be 8 pounds over. There's no fight. So first, I had to give them 2 pounds for free. So I had to re-sign the contract and give them 2 pounds for free and negotiate the other six. He still wasn't trying to cut nothing, right? So he ended up paying me, you know, out of his purse for that.
Yeah.
And I beat him. It was a split decision. He wasn't trying to engage at all. You know, the original video, people were just asking me about the fight today. I wanted to see it. And look, you can find it on YouTube, but it's the original video back then. Just people had a TV contract or something, and they couldn't post the original. So the only video you find on YouTube is somebody from the crowd. Can't see it all that good. But hey, that loss is in this record forever. You can come and avenge it anytime.